Hello, welcome to this video. In this video I would like to show you a few advanced network monitoring scenarios using System Center Operation Manager and two ISV products, namely Yalesoft Xeon Network Manager and Savvision Live Maps. So here we have an environment where we've already implemented network monitoring using Yalesoft, and we will now start using the Live Maps authoring console to create a simple networking diagram. So to be able to use the network objects that are discovered in my Ops Manager environment, I will create a new object set, especially for the Yalesoft devices. So here I have all the switches and routers that are discovered in my environment. And I will start by making a simple network topology diagram. So let's start with drag and drop some of the router objects on my drawing. If you need some more space, you can set a alternate resolution for the drawing. Let's first show some discovered properties of the object. We can do that by changing the label of the object. So in this case, I want the model and the IP address. And let's now add some network cloud information. You can use the network connector to connect the objects, and you can associate one of the monitored devices on the router with that network link. So if one of those objects go into a critical state, the light will also show up critical. We also have a connection to the internet. So between this router and the internet, there's actually a firewall, which is not monitored by Operations Manager. But what I've done, I've created a perspective that is watching this firewall. And I'm going to place that into the network drawing. And going to change the image. Add some switches to the drawing. And change the label of the switches. So what I've also have done is create a perspective that is checking the internet connection from a specific site. And we can also add that information to the topology. So we do not only know that the monitored devices are healthy, but also that the user experience is still okay. So this is an example topology for a very simple environment. If you have a more complex environment, you might want to use the nesting capabilities of live maps to create multiple layers. And you can then group the network objects in each site in different ways. You can do it manually by creating a topology for each site. You can also use the site and subnet wizard, which will create dynamic lists for you for every site. So in this case, we have a dynamic list that's based on IP information and is automatically discovering the network devices in that site. Another example is creating a more sophisticated topology manually by using live maps and drag and drop all the objects on a on the topology view. So if you've grouped your network objects by location, you can use live maps to create an overview map. In this case, I will drag and drop the Amsterdam site on the overview map. I'm going to change the image. We're going to use the network connection from live maps to display the health of the network link. In this case, we select one of the interfaces monitored by Jellysoft. And we have another connection to the internet. We can select one of the interfaces, or you can select a perspective. So if the perspective is going into a critical state, the line will also show critical. So let's have a look at this from the Operations Manager console. So here's the topology we've created, the simple topology. Here is the more complex topology. And by double clicking on the site, we will go into the detailed topology. And for the Redmond site, we don't have created a diagram, but just an automatic grouping of objects. And we see there's something wrong with the router. We can start a performance view, which gives you an indication of the current load of the router. And you can also run the Health Explorer to identify what the problems are on that device. So there are a few ways to share this information with your organization. One is, of course, the Microsoft Operations Console. But you can also incorporate the views into a SharePoint website and still have the interactive maps, so you can still drill down. Another option is using the Live Maps web console. Which allows you to share these views via a web browser. And you will not only be able to identify the problem, but from here we have an integration with the Operation Manager web console. It still allows you to diagnose and troubleshoot the problem in further detail. And upcoming in our next release, there will also be a Vista gadget, which will show you the state of a specific view with a flyout to the actual view. So to quickly recap this video, we've seen a few ways of how you can use ISV products to extend Microsoft Operations Manager for network monitoring. In this case, we've used the Jellysoft networking solution and sufficient live maps to create topology diagrams. We've created a simple diagram and a more complex diagram, which allows you to create nested views and have access to all standard Ops Manager functionality. Thank you.